issuing accounts. We have any plan? Which one? We have only one page layout now. Search layout, mobile layout, those are different. But system where you can have account. Yeah, standard layouts. These are already assigned to those people, those profiles. I am a system administrator, I have one layout, but I don't want to utilize this. I wanted to utilize a custom one. Yes, for one object can have multiple page layouts and record types. But the problem here is, do we have only one record type we have? So you can't assign more than one page layout now. The record type is page layout here now. But once you create your own record type, this record type will get updated to the record type which you created. So now I just introduce a new field. Pick list value sets. New global pick list. Brands. Just create a brand, mobile. Computer, automobiles, DALs, dealers. So this is my global value, which was introduced in 2015. Before it was not there. At Spring 16, it was introduced. The global values, I mean, you can define whatever static values here, and you can use in a object field creation of pick list or multi select. Either you can, I just created one pick list value sets as a global value. Now I'm going to accounts. Okay, if you create a pick list via account, I have a brands of four. Tomorrow if I had another brand, I have to add, right? I created the same pick list value more than 50 times in different places. All 50 times I need to update. But if I enter the global pick list value, if it is a standard of my business, then if I enter a new value, all 50 places will get updated automatically. One place configuration will reflect everywhere. Not, we are not restricting. Or not even restricting here, I understand. You have something like you have 10 rupees and you have, or not this one. Consider that you created one brand pick list in an account object. You also created one brand pick list in a contact object. I say that let's add a new brand called present. If I say new brand, how many places you need to add now? Both the places. So you need to do a maintenance. Assume that if it is a two places, fine. What if you forget in some place? So global pick list is something like, if the business is standardized for some pick list process, then create a global pick list and refer those in a custom objects, the field which you are going to create. Now what happened, whenever you select a pick list, it will ask you two options. Before it was not there, recently it came up. Either it will ask, I am just selecting pick list. Now you can see, use a global pick list value sets or enter value. This is what we do generally. If I have a user group list, now I can select my brands. So whenever there is a change, new brand added there, it will reflect automatically here. The values will get flown continuously. Global pick list reflect here. Yeah. So one place configuration will reflect entire environment. Main that will reflect here. We should put next, save. Now let me go to the accounts. Okay, accounts. I'm just open. We have a brands here. right? Dealers, mobiles, automobiles. So let me add a new brand, as we are saying that we'll see even that now. Quick list, value sets. Open the brand, new pick list, new value. I mean, say, let me talk about Salesforce or service. So one place maintenance will reflect everywhere. So you don't want to worry for a multiple configurations. So it doesn't mean that every pick list you need to create like this. If there's some pick list, consider that if it is a brand at account level, might be it is constant across my pro. If it something is constant across my organization is same, then I'll go with the brands. I mean pick list, global pick list. If it is something like opportunity status process. So if my status process always, first you need to place a request, and then in progress, and then approved or rejected or any comments. This is my approval process in my company standards. If this is the standard, I can create this process in a global pick list. I can refer, if tomorrow, if I added a new step, I can able to add directly in that same step. So it will reflect my entire standard process. Instead of updating each standard, each vertical by vertical, I can update at one place. It will reflect at same moment. So only it is named as a global pick list. And it is came on some Spring 16. It was not there before, it came on Spring 16. And another point, no, Spring 15, not 16, last to last year. And this year on November, we had a new field called Time Field. That's a beta version. So it's okay. First release, it would be beta and then it will update. It's a winter 18 release update. So what happened, if you ask, it was requested by a Dover event. So I'll show you something. It have a reason in it. I'll show you.